I'm Alex. Let me take you on a tour of my motorsport themed cafe. I'm Alex. Let me take you on a tour of my motorsport themed cafe, Fast and Furious Cafe. And let me tell you a little bit about the displays that we have inside and the interesting stories behind some of them. All right, let's go. Okay, let's start with this. These are just some of the model displays that I have. Schumacher, and these are signed autographs from my friend Eddie Irvine, the ex-F1 driver. And basically just a lot of model, scale models of cars and bikes. Okay, move on. We have here Steve Martin's mannequin of his gear, his racing gear that he used for the Northwest 200. That's Steve there, and that's him. And this is a sequence photograph of his crash while wearing that suit. You can see here that the even the helmet, it's the original helmet from the crash. This poster here of Kim McConnell. I get all the overlanders from all over the world when they come and visit the cafe. I get them to sign. You know, they're from Germany, from Indonesia, from Japan. And we have reading material for our guests. That is the original wheels from my NSX. It was a manual NSX from 1991. And I had it for 11 years and sold it, unfortunately. That's my dog. Some of you may know this dog, Repsol. That's when she was still very young, just after I picked her up from the road. And I used to take her for rides on my scooter. And that's her helmet. She's outgrown the helmet now. That over there is a just a small kid's bike, but it runs on petrol. A friend gave it to me. His son outgrew it. This is the BMW HP2. Only 13 in Malaysia, 11 official ones. This is number 11. I love this bike. It's got the GS liquid cooled engine. Sorry, the air cooled engine. Okay, this is just some stuff I took from the tour. I just snatched it off the streets once the race was ended for the Tour de Langkawi in Kuching, the Kuching leg. That's the official MotoGP Yamaha team shirt from, I think, 2018. I used to be an F1 photographer, and this is a photograph I took of Mika Häkkinen. I think it was in Australia or maybe in Sepang, I'm not sure. Okay, here we go. My race plate from the old days when I was racing jet skis for Petronas. That's a signed scale model of the Eros car, signed by Tora Takagi and Pedro de la Rosa. And these are just scale models of cars that I have been connected with in some way or another. Here we go. This is an old magazine cover, and this is the exact model of the heli I used to fly, the Robinson R44. is the Valentino Rossi replica helmets. It belongs to a friend of mine, Ong Sang. This is also his collection, a Rossi full riding gear, full suit. This BMW Motorrad gave me this club banner. Okay, this is a practically new Yamaha trail bike, the TYZ. Scottish, they call it. It's a trail bike, you know, for jumping rocks and stuff. I don't do that kind of riding, but this is just a part of my collection. This flag here is very special. It means a lot to me. I carry this flag throughout most of my overseas competition, especially in Australia. For the final round of Australia, this is the flag. I hid it on my boat and I pulled it out and was waving it. This is the actual flag. This is my Petronas hat. When I was racing for Petronas, I raced with the Petronas team for I think 11 years. Okay. My favorite table in the place. Okay, that's this is my personal map of places I've been. This is Europe. My route, as I did on my bike, and that's the Central Asia, right, from Kuala Lumpur up through, you know, Laos, Thailand, into China, into Mongolia, into Russia and Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan. That's the trip I did in 2014. And this is my US ride. Sorry about the shadow, but this is my US ride. Pan America from Argentina up through Chile, Bolivia, Central America, Costa Rica, Nicaragua, Honduras, and all that, all the way up through US, Canada, up to Prudhoe, Alaska. Basically from the bottom of the world to the top of the world. This is just something I put up one day, a few years ago. I encourage visitors to the cafe to put up their currency and just to sign on it. And I went off for a trip. When I came back, it was already full like this. So these are jerseys, mountain bike jerseys that were manufactured by my company, Single Track Mind. And when the company went bust, I kept the name and used it for my band. So. This is a 1982 Ferrari 308 GTS Quattro Valvole. It's leaving the cafe tomorrow after being parked here for 5 years. So that's a Ferrari mountain bike, one of two that I have. The other one's over there. That is the cycling jersey won by our Olympic cyclist Josiah, and he gave that to me to display here. He wore that during the Olympic Games, so it's quite significant. I've lots of posters of Alex Jung. My friendship with Alex goes back a very, very long way. That is Billy McConnell. He won the UK Super Sport Championship. This is a signed glass Schumacher, my Schumacher. This thing here is rather personal, so I won't talk much about it. But it's related to this display of this helicopter. Yeah, some more models, scale models. Harley Davidson's, etc., and my collection of Ayrton Senna scale models of his race cars. More helmets here. This flag is my race retirement flag. When I stopped racing, all the teams a lot of team riders, they all signed a goodbye to me. Basically, so I kept it all these years. That's my race boat up there.
from the World Championship. And it's just a few stories about my Pan America ride. That's my team, Petronas. That's me looking very young. And my teammates. This is a special bike. It's a Bimota DB7. It's got the it's a Bimota chassis with a Ducati 1098 engine. The same motor that's in the Ducati Street Fighter. This is one of my collection, and it's a zero mileage. I've never started it. It's brand new, really, and it's 12 years old. A 12 years old brand new bike, basically. You know this guy, but Valentino Rossi. I keep a lot of stuff, memorabilia, like old shell FOMO stuff. This is an Aprilia 125, 125 two-stroke bike. Okay, let's go up here. That's me, long time ago. That's my training bike, training ski, and. That's the same ski in that photograph. I've taken the motor out, and now it's just hanging on display. Now what you see here is the Aeros 1999 Aeros F1 show car. It's modeled after the F1 car that was driven by Pedro de la Rosa and Toru Takagi. I was involved with the team from a sponsoring company point of view. So this car was given to me by the team owner, who has since passed away, unfortunately. This is a Moto Guzzi V7 Chromo. It's never been started. It's also one of my zero mileage bikes. It's I think it's a 2014 maybe. So it's now 7 years old. And brand new. I've never even heard the engine because we never started it. So let me show you another view of the F1 car. There we go. And over here I have the collection of books, mostly about motorsport, including my book, of course. So visitors to the cafe, they can take a book from here and just read on the premises. These are some of my trophies, the King's Cup, and a few others. And again, some trophies from Australia, New Zealand, so on. I won the Australian Championship in 96. And this is some US riders, some friends. My team, my race team. And it's one of my retired helmets. I've got so many of them in the same color, retired. That's my uniform from that back then. Yeah, it looks rather big, but they always gave us oversized uniforms. Look at this guy. Don't look anything like that right now. Okay, so this is 1993. No, 95. Young, mean, and hungry then. This is a RS4. It's a 125, but four-stroke. Again, a zero-mileage bike, sort of, technically. This is the Billy McConnell's winning championship commemorative t-shirt. They sent that to me, so pretty cool to have it here. That's one of my race plates. These are photographer jerseys, because I was a photographer for motorsport, so we had to wear these to be able to get on the track. Yeah. And again, one of Alex Jung's posters. This is from Bruce Conrad, who used to race the Baja 500. He raced it many times, 17 times if I'm mistaken. It was one of his winning trophies he gave to me to display here. Okay, that is a RSV250 Suzuki two-stroke. I love this bike, very proud of it. And these are all my passes from, well, not all of them, just a few of them from my days being involved with Formula One and Formula Asia, etc. I have a lot of these motorcycle club mementos. I keep them here. It's a photo of me on a mountain in Laos about 6 years back. So, yeah. Some other racing stuff. That's my buddy Zanlo, who raced in the GT Championships in Asia and also in Europe. That's Ayrton Senna's helmet. And a few other of Senna's cars up there. Again, a lot of my ex-race plates and race jerseys. This is our little bar. Okay. More of my retired helmets. They're everywhere. One of my Petronas helmets, my Malaysian Airlines sponsored years, that I wore that. I wore that mainly for occasional Sepang track days and a few tests for Formula Asia, Formula Ford or whatever it is, but I was never fast enough, so.
Excuse me.
This is the t-shirts that we sell. You know, a lot of people want to bring something back when they're here. Something back to remind them of their visit to Fist and Furious Cafe. Okay, this is a work in progress here. I brought my drum set here because we're setting up a stage for after COVID. We're going to have live performances here. I don't think I showed you everything, but here you go. Here's an overall view of the cafe. This is the helmet cloud. I just asked everyone, bikers and all that, they got helmets that they don't use anymore, to hand them to me, and then I hang them up for posterity. Okay, here we go. That's my Australian Championship trophy, and these are all F1 helmets. That's a helmet from Alex Hume's helmet that he gave to me, and these are all helmets that are part of Hong Seng's collection. You can see Alonso, you know, Hamilton, etc. Schumacher, Nicky Hayden, Wayne Gardner. Anyway, guys, I can't possibly show you everything in a short video. But here you go. This is in general, this is what it looks like. This is Alex. Say hello to Alex, my partner.
Hi guys.
Alex keeps this place in top shape because I'm always traveling, so I'm never here usually. But yeah.
So whenever you guys come here, you can just call either Alex Ho, Alex Wong, both will answer you.
The two Alexes.
Yes.
All right. So see ya.
Bye.